Hi friends, what's on my mind today? Well, I drew out some plans to make another can shelf in the pantry in my motorhome. So I'm starting to lay out the saw pattern here. Please enjoy my stories or whatever else might be on my mind today. I like to draw out everything on my board before I cut. And that's what we're doing now. So, 5 1/8. 5 1/8. This allows me the most efficient use of my board, and it gives me the biggest piece left over because I've planned it all out to maximize the use of the material. And I've gotten it all drawn out, and the next step is to saw. I have a little block of wood, which is an essential part of my saw. So what I'm going to show you here is that this, from the blade to the edge of the saw, that's the measurement. So when I want to saw on the line right here, I've measured this from that line on both ends. And that allows me to saw a straight line exactly where I want it. I always kind of double check to see if I'm going to saw my table. See these lines right here? Now I claim that I put them there on purpose so that I could distinguish my table from other tables when I'm with a group. And we all get our tables out for like a potluck. But the fact is, I forgot to look underneath once. No, that's not right. I forgot to look underneath twice. For a little short run, I can saw straight enough that I don't need a guide for that one. But for a longer run, I always do use a guide if I'm building something I want to be straight. Back when I was a drama teacher teaching college kids how to use tools safely, you're building scenery for this, it doesn't really have to be perfect. We used to say it doesn't have to float. Because it's only used during the performance and then it's all torn down. Of course, you realize also that if I was in a full shop, sawdust. If I was in a full shop with a table saw and all the other kinds of tools, it would be a little easier. But I'm working with motorhome tools here, so this is how I do it. I get everything straight and true. Done. Perfect 1 inch. Sawdust. Probably should be wearing a mask. Rails, 1 by 9 5/8. Okay, 5 faces. Now we need 5 shelves. And the shelves are 4 5/8 by 9 5/8. Let's make sure I'm still square. And I am. So 4 5/8. By the way, I figured out how not to do it left-handed. I'm on the other side of the table. Not too old to learn, hey. Five shelves. Perfect. Let me show you what the plan is for this project. In here, in the bathroom of my motorhome, this area here, this is made for a washer dryer. It's plumbed back in there for that. And this would have been the dryer part. We opted not to have a washer dryer because I'd rather go to the laundromat and use 5 or 6 machines at the same time as one of those RV washing machines that takes a long time. The other thing is that it uses water and uses electricity, and those things are always something that we conserve when we're boondocking. The other thing is that those things have a flaw, and the flaw is that if you have a combination washer-dryer, the washing machine gets done and all of the water in the washing machine doesn't get pumped out. There's still a little bit here and a little bit there down the crevice and in between the drum roller and the thing that actually contains the water. There's still a little water. It's not 100% evacuation of the water, which means that not only does the dryer have to dry your wet clothes, it has to dry the washing machine.
That's why it takes 4 hours to do one load of laundry in those things.
That's why there's no washer dryer in here, but I use it as a pantry. And some couple of years ago, I built this. Let me back up so you can actually see that. It's a vertical drawer that comes out of the wall. And I call it my can pantry. Halfway in. All the way in. And so I've decided that the thing I'm building is going to attach to this door right here. So there'll be a can pantry attached to that door. And then I'm going to cut these shelves here back the distance of, well, 5 1/4 inches. And when I close that, they'll be there. And when I open that, I'll have more can pantry. And I also have the plans drawn up to put one on this door also, but it has to be narrower because of this thing. It can only be like about this wide, but it's wide enough for a can. So I can have one or two rows of cans here and four cans there, five shelves. That's the plan, augmenting my can pantry. Another day of working on my can pantry. Let's go see how it's doing. Got it assembled. Got all of the shelves spaced out to hold different things. So let's go inside and see how it's going to look on the door. Here we go. Temporarily hung. Oh, even likes to close itself. And closed. And see if it's gonna miss the... Oh, problem. Can't open one drawer, one side. How about if I move it over a ways? Let's try that. Well, it's not working. I've got it moved over as far as it can possibly go. You can't open one door. It hits. So, I've made a little mark there. That's... actually took all of this into consideration when I was drawing the plants. Something went wrong. So I'm going to cut it off back here to make it narrower. And a can and the biggest can will still fit in there. That's 10 minutes worth of work. It's not going to be anything that needs to be really great cabinet work because it's going to be on the back against the door. Doesn't matter if it is a little rough cut. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to cut the back of it off so that I can open the whole door. Okay, the big new test. Does it close and open without opening the other door? Sure enough, it's a success. Okay, what's left then is to sand and varnish. It's sanded and varnished, and I'm very happy with the way it's come out. I have lost my sunshine for today, so hanging it and stocking it with cans, that's going to wait for another day or another video. Thanks for watching. Let's go see what Lynn's doing. Hello, Lynn.
Hi.
I finished it. Well, I didn't hang it yet, but...
good.
It's all looking good.
I'm glad to hear that.
Are you liking the sunshine today?
I am liking the sunshine today.
Lots better than that cold weather last week?
Yes, very much so.
So this is my end of my video for today.
Oh, good.
Maybe you'd like to sing a little song for us.
Maybe I would.
Okay.
Reuben, I've been thinking, what in the world have you been drinking? Is it whiskey? Is it wine? Oh my gosh, it's serpentine.
Hey, if you like me, give me one of those thumbs up. And please subscribe and hit that little bell so you know when I post next. Please share me with your friends on social media. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed what was on my mind today.